God, this is the day that the Lord has made, and I shall rejoice and be glad in it. I praise God each one of you had a blessed day. I praise God that you come today to receive from the Lord some powerful word. Amen. Word of wisdom, word of knowledge, word of intelligence. Praise God. Word from the throne of grace. Praise God. God bless you, Sister Haskins. God bless you. God bless you, Mother Crouch. Amen. Good to amen. Wave at you yesterday. Amen. Through your door. Amen. Such an honor, praise God, to see each one of you, praise God. So it's awesome and great, praise God, to each one of you, praise God. Bless you, own Sister Robin, praise God. Bless you, Missionary Burgess. God bless you, Sister Clara, praise God. Deacon Spinner, bless you, praise God. Amen. Bless each one of you, bless you. God bless you, Elder Hayward, bless you. God bless you, Sister Soteria. Tell my princess, happy birthday. Bless you, own Nate Johnson, amen. Bless you on Elizabeth Jones, praise God. Bless you, Deacon Spinner. Amen. Good start today. Amen. It's just good, rich word today. Amen. About knowledge and wisdom. God bless you, Sister Darlene. Word about knowledge and wisdom, amen. Something we cannot get enough of. Something. God bless you, Sister Frieda. Amen. I pray my daughter's over there doing something, being behaving over there, Sister Frieda. Bless you, Sister Yafet. Amen. Each one of you, praise God. Amen. Today, praise God. I pray that you've been blessed all day. Amen. Good word for us today. Let's go to work. Amen. Please share out. Amen. Let's encourage. Praise God. Because I haven't figured this out. Amen. Because I don't know how to do it yet. I need you all to be blessing. Praise God. Several people are saying, brother, we want you, amen, to bless us, to help us to get it out. I just haven't figured it out. Until I get that down pack, praise God. Until I figure out how to do it, I need you all to be sharing it out. And maybe some of my friends, amen, can get it, amen. But I just don't know what in the world I'm doing so wrong not to be able to share it. It just comes up kind of weird on my screen, praise God. I try to come up under some of you all and share it, but it doesn't work so well with me. So if you be blessed, if you would bless your pastor well enough and actually get it out there and share it for me, praise God, it would be a blessing, amen, to me, praise God. Oh, maybe share now. Okay, share group. Amen, I thought I had something going there. Okay. All right, so well, praise God. Let's go to work. All right, y'all share it. God bless you, my nephew. Share out there, praise God. Let's go to work. We don't have time. God bless each one of you out there, praise God. Amen. Good word. Listen, it's about wisdom tonight, praise God. Intelligence, amen, is absolutely critical, praise God, today. Amen. I learned something a long time ago, praise God. Listen to this. This is going to bless some of you real, real well, and you're going to catch this. You know what I learned, praise God, I was in the military for 20-some-odd years, and then going into the corporate world, praise God, where, amen, I learned, praise God, a lot, amen, that just because of my position, praise God, I was in charge of a lot of people. That didn't mean, praise God, that I knew all their jobs. I was just in charge of a lot of people, amen. And I learned a long time ago, check this out, people do not know what you know or how much you know until you open your mouth. Come on, somebody. Now watch, let me say this again. People do not know what you know and how much you know until you open your mouth. Amen. People don't know how intelligent you are, how unwise you are, or how stupid you are until you open your mouth. So the first part of being intelligent and wise, praise God, is sometimes just don't open your mouth. Oh, help me, somebody. Come on, praise God. I have learned so much, praise God, for just being quiet, amen, and listening, gleaming, amen, receiving, praise God, and not always having the answer. Oh, y'all not helping me out. Before I even get started, intelligence sometimes, the most wisest thing you can do is get a download, praise God, instead of always having to upload. Amen. The Bible said we can learn from a child, praise God. I know I'm getting right on some people's feet already, praise God. So let's go to work, praise God, with our word for the day, amen. Let's go to work, praise God. Is that all right? I know y'all going to love me, praise God. We're coming from Hosea, praise God, the fourth chapter and the sixth verse. It said, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge because they reject knowledge. Let us do prayer. Heavenly Father God, we thank you, Lord, for the day. We thank you for the mercy, grace, and love and kindness. We thank you for a day that was not promised to us and how you just blessed us and kept us all day long, God. We're so thankful and grateful, God, for what not for you, God, what would we be and what could we be? But, Lord, you just blessed us. Now, Lord, until this This ability, God, what we're getting ready to study tonight, what you're giving pastor to give us, God, let it come from an anointing, God, that has never seen before. Let this man preach, God, and teach, God, under a greater anointing that he did not expect, in the name of Jesus. Now we expect it, God. We only expect from on high from you. We thank you in advance, God, for what you're going to do and what we're going to hear. Now bless us, God, with a great download. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Praise God, amen. Intelligence is the word today that, amen, we entered another eye, amen, into the relationship. When that relationship series, relationship, amen, we know is the way in which two or more people, praise God, or an organization regard each other and behave towards each other, amen. Is that all right? In the state of their connection, praise God. Some of the related words that you'll find in a relationship is going to be connection, relations, association, link, corresponding, parallel, praise God, alliances, bonds, in connection, and interconnection, praise God. We said, praise God, in that word relationship, praise God, we dealt with a lot of different topics, amen, didn't we? We dealt with relationship, we dealt with we dealt with love, we dealt with activity, we dealt with trust, we dealt with intimacy, we dealt with open, trust, we dealt with a lot of different areas. We dealt with honor, praise God, intimacy, praise God. And tonight, praise God, we're dealing with, amen, intelligence. Now, praise God, it's absolutely critical, praise God, that we walk in wisdom, praise God, when we are in God. There's absolutely no other way around it. I am telling you, praise God, the devil wants you, praise God, in no other way. Now, listen to this. I looked this up, and I love the way it says, wisdom is the capacity to see things from God's perspective and respond according to the spiritual principles. Let me say that again. Wisdom is the capacity to see things in God's perspective. Come on, someone. And respond according to the spiritual principles. Automatically, praise God, that's exactly what I want you to know. We need to have wisdom that we can operate in God's principles. We don't need to operate, praise God, in our own principles. We need to, praise God, have the wisdom of God, amen, that we operate in his principles and in the way he has us to operate. I need an amen, praise God. I need somebody to help me out tonight because, amen, this is where we lack sometime, and this is where, praise God, the enemy has the ability to come in and kill, steal, and destroy. This is how sometime we find ourselves falling short because, amen, we lack this ability to walk in the wisdoms and operate in the principles that God wants us to do. Amen. I looked in the Bible. I really did this because I wanted to find something. Ignorance. The word ignorance is in the Bible 32 times. 32 times do I see the word ignorance. So there is a concern of being ignorant. We don't need to be ignorant, praise God, as being the children of God. We don't need to be ignorant, praise God, because we are God's children. Somebody help me out. I need some help right there. I have been ignorant long enough, praise God. I was unwise when I was not saved. That was ignorant all by itself. Y'all not helping me. I'm by myself already. I'm not getting no amen. I'm not getting no thumbs up because it's going to be real and raw tonight. Because it's important, praise God, that we catch, amen, this information tonight. Is that all right? Praise God. Somebody give me amen before I even get good and started. Praise God. Amen. Now, let me explain something to you about this. In a relationship, let me talk to you. We're talking about a relationship. In a relationship, I've learned some people have a better skill. I've seen, praise God, maybe in your relationship, I like tinkering with cars. I love tinkering with them. Maybe, praise God, the lady, amen, that God sends in my life don't have that ability. So, amen, she's going to be blessed, praise God, because I'm able, amen, to get out there and work on my car and operate and build and do those things. And maybe, praise God, she may be good at numbers or maybe good at writing, and I'm not. So sometime in a relationship, there's some people, amen, in that relationship may be stronger in one area, come on somebody, and the other is weakened in another area. And it's nothing wrong with that. It's nothing wrong with knowing that your partner, come on, y'all better hear me, it's okay to know. That don't mean that you don't have abilities. That means that they are stronger in abilities. See, this is part of wisdom already, intelligence. Amen. It's good to know what your strengths are in your partnership and in your relationship. So tonight, praise praise God. We, praise God, I want to let you know that, praise God, the relationship you're in with God, he has all the knowledge that you need. Oh, help me somebody. Well, your strength, he has the strength and wisdom that you're going to need to operate and to live successfully and to have 100% life and a blessed life. So praise God, tonight as I teach you, I don't want you, amen, to apply anything that you know. I want you to use everything that God has to give to you. Can I get one more amen out of this thing tonight? I don't want you, praise God, amen, to put any of your part in there. I want you to use everything he has. Usually, praise God, in a relationship, I want you to apply your piece and their piece. But now I want you to drop all the things you may know and begin to allow God to use his abilities, his knowledge. All right? If that makes sense, amen. So first of all, I want you to drop everything you used to think was the way. That's the first part of good wisdom. Somebody said, if I want to be smart, the first thing I need is drop what I thought was right. Oh my God, that starts off good. Is that all right? Now listen to this. This is why I tell you this. It says in 1 Corinthians 2 and 14, the natural person does not accept the things of a spiritual God. Listen to that. The natural, in other words, the carnal person, the person of the world, people of natural thinking cannot accept the spiritual things of God, for they are folly to them. In other words, they're foolish. They don't understand them. They can't comprehend them, praise God. And they're not to be able to understand them because they are spiritually discerned. What he's saying, praise God, that amen, that when you're not, praise God, in a spiritual mindset, if you're not connected to God, come on, someone, you're not going to understand God's ability. Amen. You cannot, praise God, walk around, praise God, and expect to understand how God wants you to operate. Talk to me, saints of God, if you're not connected into this relationship. You got to, praise God, not only say you're saved, you got to have this relationship with God that you can understand what God wants you to do, and you're going to understand why. Remember, put a nugget by that. Somebody write, put a star by what I just said. Because it can be folly to a person, amen, when they're living all day in the world, listening to the things of the world, attaching themselves to the world, and then want instructions from God. Oh, help me, someone. They won't be able to understand it. Put an asterisk by that because I'm going to go somewhere with this. Colossians 3 and 2 says, set your mind on things above and not these things on earth. It is telling us, praise God, listen to this, that, amen, that we have not to, amen, allow the world to saturate our mind to, amen, that we got so much going on that we so attached to these things out here that we can't tap in to the resources that we need to have our mind. Now, I don't want you to be so godly that everything you walk around, God bless you, hallelujah. I don't want you to be so heavenly good that you know earthly nothing. Amen. I'm not saying that, but I want you to be attached to God. Here's my saying. 1 John 2 and 15 says, in the world, but not of the world, not of it. That's my saying of it. In the world, but not of it. For you look at it, it said, in the world, but not of it. That's my cliche too. 1 John 2 and 15. It's telling us, praise God, we're going to have to operate in this world. We're going to have to be around this world. We have to deal with this world. We have to do the things in this world, but we can't be about this world. We can't try to keep up with the Joneses. We can't try to be like everybody. We can't keep up with everything that's going on in this world. Come on, see, I ain't getting a whole lot of thumbs up. I knew this wasn't. See, I'm talking about intelligence. I'm talking about wisdom tonight. I am trying to guide you to a successful relationship. I'm trying to guide you to your greatest blessing. I'm trying to guide you to, praise God, the greatest thing that you're ever going to have in your life. I'm trying to guide you, praise God, to the promises of the greatest blessings. I'm trying to guide you, praise God, to what's going to glean you, praise God, because we're going to have to drop. It says, let this mind be in you. Ah, shut up, Omasha. It said, let it be in you, praise God. Let it drop, and you have a desire to have this mind of Christ. Amen. And this is what it takes, that we can't, amen, allow everything of this world. We can't, amen, want everything of this world. We can't, amen, every time something comes out, every this and that and that. We don't need to know every dance. We don't need to know everything that's happening in the street. We got to keep our mind to a place. Talk to me, saints of God, that, amen, it won't seem folly. Because see what, I'm going to help you in a minute. See, because this is what happened. See, if we can't, we got to be so careful because the world want to trick us. I'm going to tell you. Amen. See, we can't use all the world's tricks and trades to accomplish the things we need to accomplish. We cannot use all the world's tricks and trades to accomplish what we need to accomplish. We cannot use all the world's tricks and trades to accomplish what we need to accomplish. We cannot use all what the world uses to accomplish the things we need to accomplish. Let me give you a prime. Oh, shut up on my shop. See, God's ways may look different from the world's. I need 10 billion, amen. Y'all should be blowing this thing up. God's ways is absolutely looks different than what the world's do. That's why they consider it folly. You know what? Praise God. I remember, praise God, I read somewhere that there was a man by the name of Noah. Amen. They said that he was in a desert place. And he, amen, and said it took him years. It said many and many years. And they said he was in the middle of a desert building a boat. Amen. And said he had kids and they would go to school and go to town. And he was out there building a boat. And people looked at him like he was stupid. And they would say, well, why in the world would you build a boat? And he kept telling me it was going to flood. Come on, somebody. God's so different. Amen. But he built the boat anyway. But I tell you what, I guarantee you everybody now thinks Noah was the smartest man on earth. Talk to me, somebody. Talk to me, saints of God. I need a whole lot of amen. Y'all better hear me. Tell the truth. See, you got to understand, God's way may seem folly to the world, but when we trust in the Lord with all our heart and lean not to our own understanding, that's wisdom all by itself. And when Noah, praise God, continued to build the ark, though people probably laughed at him and ridiculed and talked behind his back, I guarantee a whole bunch of them knocked on that door of that ark and said, let us in, because all of a sudden he was the most smartest man he could ever be found. So praise God, you're going to be peculiar. You're going to be unique. You're going to be different, praise God. You're going to not be the same. That's because you're special. You're a royal priesthood, so you can't be the same. Royalty is not like everybody. You can't be like common folk. You're going to think different. You're going to act different. God's going to deal with you different. Somebody say amen to me. I'm talking about intelligence tonight, praise God. I'm talking about wisdom, praise God. So our ways cannot be. God's ways are different, praise God. Listen to this. Isaiah 55:8. Everybody's heard it forever, and I don't know how many of us want to live with it. It says, my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor my ways your ways, declareth the Lord. The Lord declareth that his ways are not going to be the ways of the world, not the ways that we think. Amen. And what we're going to have to do is drop everything. That's why I told you in the beginning that in this relationship, you're going to have to surely, praise God, believe, amen, that your ways are not good. Y'all not helping me. I know this was going to destroy. I knew. I prayed on this today. I pray that some of you will love me through this. I pray that some of you will support me through this. I pray that some of you will receive through this, praise God, because it's going to challenge us, amen, in this relationship to stop thinking the way we think and stop operating the way we want to operate and begin to say we got to do it this way, because I really want 100% of what God has for me. And if it's going to take me out of the mindset that I'm in, it's going to take me out of my normalcy to get all that God has for me, count me in, praise God. And this is what it's all about. Can I get 10 more amens in this place? So saints of God, what I'm talking to you about, praise God, is that, praise God, his ways is not going to be our ways. Amen. If you have been saved longer than 2 minutes, if you've been saved longer than two minutes, you can already see that the world's ways are not like God's ways. It does not. If you've been saved 2 minutes, you automatically can see that they're not the same. The world will tell you, praise God, amen. The world tells you to look out for yourself at all expense. It's going to tell you, praise God, to take care of you, you, me, myself, and I. That's the key thing the world tells you, praise God. The world tells you immediate gratification is the best thing you can have. The world tells you that happiness is what you need, and that's it. And the world tells you it don't matter whose back you climb on, as long as you get to the top. That's what the world tells you. Talk to me, saints of God. Is that right, praise God? Isn't that what it says, praise God? Amen. But James 1:5 tells us, if any man lack wisdom, let him ask of God. Somebody said, well, hold it. I'm doing pretty good climbing on people's back. Why do I need any wisdom? Because there's a better way and there's a greater way. Don't you know there's a right way and a wrong way to do anything? But if you tap into God for your resource, help me someone. Now, I begin to say, okay, he keep hollering, hey, man, well, you need all this wisdom. How do I get my wisdom? Where do I get this wisdom from? Tell me this, you all that big wolf and all that talk. You tell me where I get it from. Yeah, I be asking for it. Yeah, I be needing it. Well, come on. The first way you can receive wisdom is by, let me blow your mind. I know some of you are going to say, what? This right here, the word of God. This is your best. Oh, see, now, y'all should be blown. Y'all should break the internet right now. Y'all should give me so many thumbs up. Praise God. Those saints of God, those, amen, that have came through, those, amen, that didn't have anything else, praise God, but the word of God, amen, didn't have the internet. Some of us, praise God, didn't have the internet when we came through. Some of us, praise God, didn't have anything else but this right here. And this gave me the way to walk, talk, and to live. I, amen, been able to learn how to deal with difficult folks. This told me how to manage my money. Come on, this told me, praise God, how to pray through difficult times. This told me how to deal with fear. This told me how to deal with my enemies. Y'all not trying to hear me. Somebody help me out. This was the greatest, praise God, book of wisdom I ever had. Oh, y'all ain't trying to help me, praise God. This was my book of wisdom. Amen. This is the first place, God. It taught me how to deal with adversary. It taught me how to deal with faith. It taught me how to deal with difficult. Amen. I learned a lot from that, praise God. I learned so much from this, praise God. Amen. I got so good, praise God, of loving this. Amen. I begin to call this my manual. My manual. My manual ability to operate. Amen. This is my book of operations of my life, praise God. Everything in my house got a manual to it. It got a book of instructions. This is my book of instructions. Y'all, I know. So, oh, that's how easy it is. Yes, that's just how easy it is. When you get on your knees, check this out. Before I open this book to study, the first thing I do is say, God, I get on my knees and say, God, give me discernment. God, give me wisdom. Break it into me. God, let the flow of this knowledge bless my life. That when I open this word, God, that it'll be revelation word down on the inside of me. God, that when I read it, God, it give me revelation understanding. You ain't hearing me. And then, praise God, when I finish, I say, God, I thank you for what I read. And I decree right now, not only did I get revelation word out of it, that I begin to operate in it, God, that it became a part of my life in the name of Jesus. See, that's what I'm talking about. And I begin to recite and remember what I read. I don't care if it's two words. I don't care if I remember. I don't may know it by verbatim every scripture, but I remember the story. I stay in it, praise God, because that's my beginning of wisdom. Y'all don't hear me. Hallelujah. Now, that's the beginning of wisdom, praise God. Then, praise God, when you're there, amen, and you start your first step of wisdom, then you begin to get on your knees. You begin to fast and pray. You begin to seek God for downloads. I begin to tell y'all, listen, that prayer life, the reading of your word, fasting and praying, y'all ain't hearing me. God will begin to shape you and mold you and give you wisdom, praise God, and begin to touch your hands and give you gifts and talents and guide you and lead you. Praise God. Somebody said, well, how in the world you know to do that? And you'll be saying, I have no idea. Somebody, how in the world you ever was able to do that? I have no idea. You begin to know it's favor and only by the divine glory of God. You begin to have that wisdom and knowledge and don't know where you learned it from. It's just a gift and talents that God begin to pour into your life and give you that wisdom that come from above. Somebody help me out. I would have never thought I knew as much as I know about this word. I would have never known, praise God, how much I know. I don't know nothing about nothing else as much as I know about this. And it's only because of the grace of God. It's not because I've been all that much of a great steward. Yeah, but I've just been blessed because of my instruction book. Y'all ain't trying to hear me, praise God. Somebody said, wisdom, amen, is what I'm about. Somebody said, intelligence tonight in my relationship. Somebody say amen to me, praise God. Now, I wanted you to be this. Now, I told you all that, but I want you to be aware of a couple of things. The first thing, you got to stay alert. Because, praise God, you got to watch out, praise God, because there's a great enemy called the devil that, amen, every time, praise God, you're seeking, amen. When we're reading this word, praise God, when we're starting to tap into this word, praise God, for this wisdom and instructions, and, amen, when we start looking for the intelligence or how to operate and to deal with these situations, because some situations come up. How many of you know some situations pop up right away and we need an answer right then and there? We can't go pray about it for tomorrow. That's an issue that happens. Y'all not trying to help me. There are some issues, praise God, that happens right now. And you got to know, praise God, and you can't hold it. You got to have that word in your heart, but you got to go. You got to find that word. Anybody else with me? And you got to have a word right then and there. And you got to be very careful. You got to be alert. Because at that time, the enemy will come in, praise God, as a flood and try to attack you. Somebody help me out, praise God. You got to be so aware, praise God, because that's when the enemy come in, praise God, as 1 Peter 5:8 says, as a roaring lion, praise God, he comes in to try to confuse you. Somebody help me out. Try to confuse you, to attack you, praise God, from the wisdom that God is trying to pour into you, trying to attack you and make you make a mistake and try to make you find the easy way out, try to make you, praise God, move in the wrong direction. The devil, praise God, don't you know he just know how to change one word? Oh, y'all ain't catch that. He changed one word. How many of you know what I'm talking about? He changed one word with Eve. He said, no. He didn't say, praise God, that you surely die. Come on, somebody. Y'all didn't hear me. Y'all didn't hear me. That's what he did. Then what he did with Jesus. Come on. He said, if thou was the Son of God, that you throw yourself off this. Because, see, he changed every time. Look at it. Go back and look at it. Every time he did it, he just slipped a different word. Amen. So what he does, praise God, is not just to slip enough in there, just enough in there to taint the whole thing. And you got to be careful, praise God, that when you're seeking it, praise God, that you know that he's there. He's trying to make you, praise God. Listen to this. Here's what he does. When you, most of all, praise God, when you are seeking God for wisdom and guidance, the first thing he does, amen, he tried to make you think about your past mistakes. Look at that. Don't sleep on it. Come on, sister. Come on, Mother Crowder. I like that, Mother Crowder. Praise God. I love that. Praise God. Amen. But listen to this. The enemy, praise God, wants to confuse you. And listen to this. I like this. He tries to make you, praise God, come up with thinking about your last mistakes. He tried to make you fear the ideas. He tried to make you weigh your options. He tried to make you come up with different things. He tried to make you think that God didn't give you the answer. He tried to make you think of all those things is not right. Y'all not hearing me. He do all these things to try to hit and trick you. When you've been seeking the Lord for wisdom, he trying to say that ain't going to work for you. Come on, somebody. He's always out there saying, no, that ain't for you because look how much you messed up. He going to try to mess that up. Oh, it worked for everybody else in the Bible, but that ain't got your name on it. Come on, somebody. But I want to tell you, the devil is a lie. It's got your name on it, praise God. Look at somebody and say, I am what it says I am. I can do what it says I can do, and there's a scripture here with my name on it, and the devil can't take it off. Somebody say amen. Y'all not helping me out tonight. I'm talking about intelligence. I'm talking about wisdom. I'm talking about what comes straight from the throne of grace, and the devil cannot steal it. Somebody say amen to me. So praise God. We're talking about it, praise God. Now, listen to this. Now, we understand the devil is going to attack us. He's going to come against us. But watch this. Watch this. What else? Watch this. Check this out. Check this out, praise God. Amen. God bless you, Panzine Graves. Hey, good to see you online. I ain't seen you in about 50 years. Praise God. Listen to this. Watch this, praise God. Listen to this. It's going to blow your mind here. Not only will the devil, praise God, come, but he also sends people. Oh, my God. People to entice you. Now, I'm going to show you something that's going to help you out. Watch this. Amen. 1 Kings, praise God, the third chapter. 1 Kings, the third chapter, amen. About starting at the fifth verse. There was a man, praise God, it says that, amen, by the name, praise God, of Solomon. He was the son of David. And it said, praise God, he went into a dream. And in his dream, praise God, God came to him and asked him in the dream, said, what may I give you? What may I give you, Solomon, my son? Whatever you ask, I will bless you. And it says that Solomon began to talk back to God and said, oh, your servant is blessed. You've given me the throne of my father. You made me, praise God, the king, amen, over your people. Your people. Keep saying your people. You've given me, praise God, all that I could ever ask. And God, all I would ask of you, give me the ability to judge your people. Listen to this. I want the wisdom and knowledge to judge your people. Check it out. Come on, watch me. Watch me. I want to have the ability to be able to do what needs to be done for your people. Go to the ninth verse, praise God, 1 Kings 3:9. Listen what it says. It says, therefore, give your servant an understanding heart to judge your people. Come on, somebody. And discerning between good and evil, for who is able to judge the great people of yours? Here's what he's saying. Check this out. When you ask God of any wisdom and knowledge and abilities, make sure that it's going to bless him. He said, God, I want to do something to bless your people. I want to do something, God, to give you glory. And what he did, it says, praise God, because he went to God like that. It says in the 9th verse, it said, now it pleased the Lord that Solomon made such a request. And it said, because he made such a request, that, amen, he didn't ask for wealth. He didn't ask for the death of his enemy. He didn't ask for any of these things, but he asked for discernment and administrative ability to judge God's people, that God gave him all that he had. Hold up, Asha. Listen, I'm going somewhere. So the first thing I'm teaching you all, saints of God, that when we go to God and ask for this intelligence and this wisdom and all this, praise God, you go to him and say, God, I want to be wise on all that I do, God, that I may live 100%, that I may glorify you in my life, and that, God, my life shall elevate the glory of you, that I may be the light unto this world. Come on, somebody. That, God, I want the wisdom to be able to operate every day, that everything I do be 100%. That God, I have glory in you. Come on, somebody. And listen to this. And then say, God, bless me whatever I do, that you will get the glory out of it. Come on. If I want to have knowledge, praise God, to be able to be the greatest financial wizard in the world. But God, I want to be such a great, that I can be the light, God, to the rest of this world. I want to be the salt, God, no matter what I do. That when they look at me to be the greatest intelligent man in the world, I'll be the greatest, amen, mathematician in the world. I'll be able to say, look what the Lord has done. Amen. If I be the most greatest real estate agent in the world, I want to be able to say, look how powerful God is. I want to be able to put a cross on the end of that thing. Y'all not hearing me? In other words, praise God, no matter what you ask God for the wisdom and knowledge of, make sure that God is going to get the glory. But here's what I'm telling you about people. Here's what I'm saying. Now, this man went to God with the right spirit. He went to God with the right heart. And God not only gave him that kind of wisdom, because the Bible said he was one of the smart, he was the smartest man to walk, praise God. Amen. He was naturally, amen, the smartest man to walk. But it tells me, praise God, listen to this. This is going to help you. 1 Kings, the 11th chapter, it told me that, amen, he has 700 wives. Now, what do I tell you? People got in his life. Check this out. The devil and people can mess you up. Amen. No matter how much God can pour in you, you got to be careful who attach themselves to you. You can't listen to every, oh, y'all better hear me. See, wisdom is that you can't be around unequally yoked. Everybody can't be in, oh, Lord, I'm 7, it's 7:02, amen. I know I'm running over, but I'm going to finish this right here. You can't let everybody in your ear. The most wisdom I can give you is that you can't have, listen, I'm going to tell you this. I know I said in the living word, amen, a whole lot of people got quiet. If your cell phone and you saying you saved, amen, if you are saved, amen, and you're with the Lord, and you are calling more folks that are unsaved all day, and you're spending 99% of your time, amen, just friendly talking to unsaved folk, and you're talking about unsaved stuff all day, amen, if that's all you talking to, amen, and you're doing all that, amen, and you don't have none but two or three solid, sanctified people that can relate back to God's word with you, you got to look at this thing and say amen. Come on, somebody. Sooner or later, you're going to mess around and get some wrong advice. You're not going to get that thing that needs to be tapped into the wisdom of God. Y'all not hearing me. I know you ain't going to love this, praise God. And this is what happened to Solomon. The next thing you know, he worshiping all kind of gods and all kind of different kind of things. But he was the wisest man. See, it does not matter, praise God, how good, how much wisdom and how much knowledge and how much gifts God give you. If you don't stay tapped into God, if you don't stay connected into this relationship, the enemy will come in as a flood and snatch what God has given you. Snatch, praise God, the blessings God has given you. And then you're walking around with a wisdom. You're walking around with all this blessing and still stupid. You're still ignorant because the enemies came in, amen, and snatched your gift and taking it and using it in the wrong way. Talk to the brother, praise God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Oh my God. Can I talk to you? So Solomon, praise God, the wisest man, went to God with the right heart, went to God with the right things. And then we find, praise God, in the 11th chapter here, he done messed around and lost it all with his mindset. Because, praise God, he got attached to the wrong people. Be careful. Be careful of the adversary. Be careful of the people that are connected with you. At this season, praise God, we are called, praise God. We are called to love on folks. But we ain't called, praise God, to hang with folk. We are called to love on them. We're called to encourage them, but we ain't called to hang with them. We got to be careful, praise God, that we're not always hanging around and being poured into, because sooner or later, what goes in you going to sooner or later come out of you. And the next thing you know, you're going to be thinking like them, acting like them, and doing like them. I used to always say this, listen to this. You hang around a gas station long enough, you're going to sooner or later come home smelling like gas. You just keep hanging around a gas station every day. Just keep coming. You're going to rub up against one of them gas pumps sooner or later and come home smelling like gas. That's what happens. When you, praise God, keep hanging around the wrong things, praise God, you're going to get tainted. You're going to get messed up with something that is not of God. So what am I saying to you? Wisdom tonight. Intelligence, praise God. Of God only, amen. We need to understand, praise God, in this relationship, when it comes down to the wisdom, when it comes down to the intelligence side, we only want to draw from God. We don't want to put any of our wisdom involved. We don't want any of our intelligence in the midst. We said, God, all of yours and none of mine. Is that all right? So this is the only part, praise God, that we don't want any of ours in. We want all of God's, amen. And I know that will be a blessing to you, praise God. Amen. I pray that you love this, praise God. I pray you got something out of this. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Tomorrow is our last piece of this. And then, praise God, we're going right into another series. Amen. We're going to be blessing you. We're going to keep going. Praise God. Amen. Keep blessing until we just tell God, tell us different. I love this. Praise God. I pray that you shared it out. If you didn't already share this, somebody needs to hear this. Somebody really needs to hear this, because the wrong person is in their ear. Everybody don't need to be in your ear. Some people telling you advice, praise God, that don't go to church. And some people telling you advice that do go to church. Everybody in church don't need to be telling you advice. If they can't come before the pastor and tell you, they ain't gonna need to tell you anyway. If it's a secret, nigga, they're a parking lot prophet. Come on, somebody. You ever got them telephone prophets? They only tell you in the parking lot and on the telephone, but can't. Well, let's take it to the pastor. Oh, Lord, I want the pastor to hear this. They don't want to do that. Praise God. That's a problem. Amen. I know that wasn't gonna go well. Praise God. But I love each one of you. Praise God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, God, give us ears to hear from you. Give us a mind to receive from you. Give us eyes, God, to only look towards you, God, in the name of Jesus. Give us a heart, God, to want to be receiving from you, Lord. Let this wisdom, God, that we talk about tonight, God, come directly from you, God. Give us, God, enough. Impart in us, God, with your mercy and grace, God. Let it pour down upon us, God, in the name of Jesus. Saturate us with wisdom, God, that we'll be able to operate in all the things you've given us to do. Own our job, raising our children, loving our husband, loving our wives, operating in our finances, God. Oh, God, everything we do, buying a car, God, doing even financing and managing our monies, God, anything we do, speaking to our neighbors, God, buying our groceries, we want wisdom, God, in all that we do. Even dealing with this pandemic, God, give us wisdom, God, where to go and how to go. We want your wisdom, God. We do not want to operate in any other wisdom but yours. We ask, God, for your mercy, grace, and loving kindness from this day forward. Touch us, God, from the top of our head to the sole of our feet. We ask, God, right now in the name of Jesus, from your wisdom and your wisdom only. And God, we repent, come on, someone, for the times, God, that I walked and did it my way. I repent for doing it my way, because I realize now, God, that my way was not the right way. And God, from this day forward, I'm asking, God, that my flesh be bound. God, I crucify my flesh, that you, God, will have the authority to lead and guide me from this day forward. Give me the wisdom, God. Give me the understanding. Give me what I need, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, even when it seems unusual to me, help me to just walk in your authority, God, because now I understand more and more, God, in this relationship, your ways are not my ways, God, and I'm not going to look at you as a natural person. I'm not going to look at you as my friend, God, as somebody I've seen every day. This is a spiritual kind of relationship, so it's not like anything I ever had before. So, God, I got to expect it to be different. I got to expect to operate different. And my relationship with you, God, is going to be stronger and wiser, because God, I'm going to live 100% and be blessed 100% and live upon every promise you've given me, God, 100% in the name of Jesus. And I claim right now, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Nothing shall stop me and nothing shall hinder me. I shall be what you said I shall be, and I shall operate in what you say I shall operate in. And God, I shall wait for your answer before I move. in the glorious name of Jesus. Now, God, have your way, Lord, upon my life, God. Even in the midst of all that's going on, I wait on you and you only, God. I will not look to the left or to the right, and I will not look to any other help, God. I listen to people because people want to give me advice, but I'll trust in your word only, God. In the name of Jesus, I've seen too many people listen to others and fall short, but God, it must come from on high, God, in the name of Jesus. So have your glorious way with us, God. Bless us, God, through this pandemic, God, as ever before. Give us, God, how and what to do, Lord. Help us, God, to be a light, God, to those that are fearful and unsure. Help us, God, to be a light, God, for those, God, that have doubt. Help us to be a light, God, unto those, God, that don't know you, Lord. Help us, God, to know that you are the author and finisher of it all. God, this is an opportunity, God, for your saints, God, to show the world of who you really is. So, God, give us, God, the bold and holy authority and the wisdom and knowledge on how to speak and what to say, how to carry ourselves and when to say and where to say it, God, in the name of Jesus. Now, Lord, favor us, Lord. Favor us from this day forward to seek you for the answer. Favor us, God, to spend that time in your word. Spend that time in prayer. Spend that time for download, that meditation time that we can receive from on high. Help us, God, to have discerning ears from you, God. Help us to have discerning, God, hearts from you, God. Help us, God, to know when that unction come to us that is from the shadow of God, the Holy Ghost, telling us how and what to do, God. In the name of Jesus, bless us, God. Now keep us, God, through this pandemic. We speak over the world, God, and all the first responders. We speak over every hospital worker. We speak over every elderly. We speak over every child, God. We speak over ourselves, God, in the glorious name of Jesus. We speak over financial issues in the name of Jesus. We speak, God, we speak, God, we speak, God, over your promises, God. We speak it, God, into the atmosphere. You shall have the glory over it all. We're going to say, we're going to praise you and say, look what the Lord has done, what is all said and done. Now, God, in the name of Jesus, as we touch and agree, God, in the atmosphere, come on, somebody. We're touching and agreeing right now, God. We're claiming together, God, in the name of Jesus, that we shall be wiser than we ever been before. We shall walk according to your wisdom, God, and we shall operate according to your will. And God, right now, from this day forward, everybody, God, that's on this broadcast, everybody else that's listening to this live stream right now, shall God have a new way of looking, shall have a new way of thinking, God, shall have a new way of walking, God, and a new way of talking, and shall see a new way, God, in the glorious name of Jesus. I claim it, God, by the power and blood of Jesus Christ. Now, God, have your way. In Jesus' glorious name, we do pray. Thank you, Lord. Hashem amasha. Amen and amen, 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 and amen. God knows I love everyone. God knows I do. Praise God. God knows I do. Hashada mama shida mashata. And that's not a thing you can do about it. Look, you be blessed. Praise God. You stay focused. Praise God. Amen. I told you ignorance is in the Bible 32 times. Don't be the 33rd person that I can say, praise God. Don't you say, I'm not going to be in there the 33rd time. I'm going to walk in wisdom and knowledge from this day forward. Praise God. The devil won't trick me. I've got God on my side. I love everyone here. Praise God. And there's absolutely not a thing you can do about it. Be blessed. See you tomorrow. Praise God. 6:30 Eastern time. God bless you.